How's it going today? And today I wanted to talk about the advanced migration of assets from one project to a completely different project. And I'm going to show you two ways to do it. And you can think of the first way as kind of a basic way and the second way as the more advanced way. What I'm showing you right here, what you're seeing on the screen, is an example of the advanced migration of assets where I've got this, what's called this Stackobot character. And I don't know if you can see him, but he's in idle mode, and he's kind of sloth-like, but you can see that he's actually moving. So it's pretty cool, and it's a great tool set to have, especially if you're working with models and characters. So I'm gonna jump over into Stackobot project. I'll go from there. So to get started on this project, the first thing you're gonna need to do is go into the marketplace and search for what's called Stackobot. And what's kind of funny is it's I call it SOB for short. So just search for Stackobot right here, and what you're going to want to do is just create a project. So go ahead and create that project, and then after you've downloaded SOB, then I'd like you to go in and just create a basic blank project with no starter content in it. Just an open world blank project with no starter content in there. And so what I'll do is I'll meet you over in Stackobot. Okay, so I'm in Stackobot right now, and as you might have discovered, this thing has like 3,852 million shaders that it has to compile. So on my system, it took about 10 minutes for this thing to finally load in. When it did, if you hit play, it looks like a pretty cool game. It's got music, and it's got this guy. Oh, what did I do with him? I guess maybe he's gone. Anyway, there's that Stackobot guy in there. I think I might have messed something up on my game. As a matter of fact, I don't know where Stackobot went, actually. If you come into the mesh, we can look for him. I have some folders in here already. But if you go into characters and you go into bot and you go into mesh, if you click on this one, this just allows us to transfer the bot himself with none of his animations or anything. And all you'd do is you'd simply right click and go to asset actions and migrate, and you'd go okay to this. And then you'd simply, using your Windows Explorer, you'd simply go to where you wanted him to go. So like, let's say I wanted him to go into this project here, I would just click on content folder and go okay, and then you'll see down here that it's been successfully migrated. Now if I want to send him with all his assets, the entire Stackobot project with his animations and the whole thing, the safest way to do that is to come over here and right click and create a new folder. And you could just call this transfer folder, or whatever you want to call it. And then what you'll do is you'll come to your Stackobot folder here, and you're going to right click and we're going to try to drag it. That's why. So I'm going to try to drag this folder into here like that. And you'll see you have move here, copy here. Both of these could be problematic because you're going to lose what are called dependencies. So those are all references to all the assets. And it'll just create a big mess, not only in this project, as you can see, because it already looks like I've messed something up by not transferring it correctly. You go to what's called advanced copy. And it'll say generate dependencies to copy, and you go OK. And then you click OK. And this is going to take a long time. This took probably about 10-15 minutes on my computer for it to do everything. But then eventually what will happen is it'll all go through. Once it's all transferred through on your folders, you click on this folder and you go migrate. You choose migrate. You'll select the content folder of where you want to transfer it to. So you'll just, if you're going to say you're going to transfer it or migrate it over here, you just click on the content directory of the project that you want to migrate everything to. And so this actually becomes a very clean way of creating a new project. So you're just getting assets in nice and clean, and they're freely working, and everything's working. So anyway, I hope you found this helpful.